Okay, let's get a lady there. This is a young lady. You want to divorce?
Yes, Baba.
I'm speaking with the lady. Are you the lady? You are together?
We are together, yes.
Oh.
Yeah.
So this one is your wife?
Yes, Baba.
And why this lady, why all of you are here now? Who want to divorce here, or who's divorcing?
It's me, Baba. I wanted to divorce here.
You're tired?
Yeah.
Let's hear the sister. You want to divorce?
Yes, I was thinking like that.
Even yourself, you want to divorce. So are you a pastor?
No.
Sister, are you a pastor?
No.
So these are no pastors. I just want to divorce. Why do you want to divorce? Why are you tired, my brother? Let's hear. I'm just taking a long time in marriage. I'm very much sad. I feel sad, to be honest. These are young people. You understand? These are young people. What is happening? All right? And they have not gone. I mean, if you are older, you understand. Can you see that brother here? This one is old. They've worked maybe some 2 to 3 years, 5 years. But these are young people. Look at Satan, what he's doing here. These are young people. Okay, why do you want to divorce, man?
It's true, Baba. It was last year.
Yeah.
I was staying somewhere, so I removed going to another place to stay there.
You alone?
Yeah, with my wife.
All right.
Then when I was staying there, there's another person who came to steal my basket.
Okay.
Then I told my wife, because that basket, I bought it from my brother.
Mm.
Then I told my wife that I don't tell anyone about this, because my brother, he was told me that he don't go that place because there's too much stealer.
Mm.
Then me, I went to that place. Then after that, our basket, it was stolen there. Then we decided to come back to the place where I was staying.
Mm-hmm.
Then when we went there, according to the promise, it was one day, I heard my brother was asking me that, I heard that your basket is stolen. Me, I was surprised because I was told my wife that don't tell anyone about that.
So the bicycle was stolen?
Yes, the bicycle was stolen and yes.
And
it was given by his brother, and he told his wife that nobody must know about it, including his brother. But he was surprised when his brother asked him, I believe your bicycle was stolen. Then that's what made him to be angry. Why does the brother knows that his bicycle was stolen?
All right. I'm just laughing because you are laughing. Let me. Can you tell me again what? Because I'm laughing because you are laughing. What happened? Can you explain? You say what?
No, it's still the same. He's concerned why his brother knows about it.
So
why he told his wife.
The story of the bicycle was between him and his wife.
His wife, yes.
So it was stolen.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, it was stolen. So it means my wife, she told my brother that my bicycle, it was stolen.
And then?
So to me, I think it was. She didn't keep the secret for me, so I wanted the divorce.
What's up, Yaman? What's up, Yaman? I'm not standing here anymore. Yeah. What's up, yeah? So you are playing with this game?
Yes.
You are playing with your wife?
Yeah.
So look here.
No, I'm not playing with her, but the problem I know that there something is wrong with me. That's why I came here, Baba.
So where do you come from?
Yeah, from Malawi. Then
they are from Malawi.
So, sister, how is your husband?
Sorry?
How is your husband?
He's fine.
He's fine.
Yes.
And how old are you, my brother?
I'm 26 now.
And the wife?
25.
I understand. Remember, listen to this. It have got nothing to do with the country. It's not things of Malawi. It have got nothing. There are some marriages, people from Malawi who are staying with their husband and their wives. This is just childish. This is just what? Childish. Brother, you need to grow up. You just need to grow up and love your wife. You understand? You must love your wife. You stay with your wife. I mean,
why I come here is because I know that I'm the one who caused the problem, because I knew that there's no story to fighting about my wife. That's why I come here. I know that maybe the devil is controlling me. That's why I came here.
Are you not having a girlfriend?
I don't have.
You don't have?
Yes.
So how is your husband? Yeah, listen to this, my brother. If you want to know you are under attack, check how you treat your wife. Because how can you love God when you raise stories like that to your wife? I mean, how can you love God? You're talking about bicycle here. This is a bicycle. I want to tell you this. The moment when you reach 20-something and you have a wife, you understand? Go and read the 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 7. Your wife, she's the determiners of your prayers. Your wife can make your prayers not to reach before God. So you go home, try to love your wife. That is why I ask you, did you marry? I doubt it. Because you have to behave. You need counseling. You go to church.
Yes, I did.
Where are you going?
Mountain Prayer Church.
Mountain?
Prayer Church.
Mountain Prayer Church?
Yes.
You go to pastor of Mountain Prayer Church, to your pastor, you go there, you need counseling with your wife. You sit down, they will counsel you. Are you hearing that? Yeah. You don't need prayer, just fix yourself. God bless you. Go sit down.
Thank you, Mom.
All right, we wanted to learn some few things. I think there's a lot of problems, whatever. But listen to this. You must never fight with useless things. Useless things. Useless. Sometimes you are sitting with your wife, you begin to say, "Why live so? Eh? Kurwanyacha, eh?" From there, go. All right. God bless you. Let me pray for Mama.